What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and you and me are going to learn how to update and deploy drivers within SmartDeploy. So let's get right into it. All right, so together we are going to learn how to update and deploy drivers within SmartDeploy, and it's super simple. All right, so once you have your SmartDeploy console up and running, you want to click on Reimage Devices, and you're going to click on Download Platform Packs. Gives you a nice little dialog box, which you are able to type in the manufacturer or the model. Now, for this example, I'm going to type in VMware. I'm going to select the first one and click on download. You're going to get a nice little dialog box. Just click OK, close it. And then from here, you want to go inside platform packs, and then you're going to see your platform pack. This right here is the VMware drivers that I'm able to push it out to my virtual machines, right? Now, from here, you're able to go inside computer management, click on all computers, select the computer that you want to push out these drivers to, and then click on update drivers. Now, one of the cool things that I like about SmartDeploy is that it is really smart behind the scenes. VMware is not a compatible driver for this machine. The reason why is BTNHD SD1 is a Hyper-V machine. So it automatically gives me a nice little warning, missing platform pack match. If you click on the drop down right here, it gives you why. There's no matching packs for this machine. You are able to click OK and click OK again, and it gives you a nice little list. It says, okay, are you sure one of these packs are compatible with this machine? And then you're able to pick it, select it, and then on the first column, you are going to see that nice little clock. And that clock basically means that it is pending. And it's not going to go. And the reason why is because this machine is running within a Hyper-V environment, not a VMware. So now for this to go successfully, we need to download the correct drivers. And I need the Microsoft Hyper-V drivers. So within platform packs, I already did that behind the scenes. It's the same way that we did with the VMware. Nothing has changed. So go back inside computer management. You're going to click on that computer that you want to deploy this package. And then when you click on update drivers, you're not going to see that red warning. Why? Because SmartDeploy automatically knows that there is a driver inside the system that's compatible for that machine. What? How awesome is that? From here, you are able to customize the update driver by allowing users to defer driver update, or you're able to schedule the deployment. If you leave everything as the default, which is unchecked, and click OK, it will automatically push it out. You will also get a dialog box to confirm it. Click OK. And on the first column, you're going to see that nice little clock, which is stating that it is pending and it is going to push it out to your machine. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up. Don't forget about smashing that subscribe button. And also don't forget about hitting that notification bell to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.
SmartDeploy, the only way to manage remote PCs over the cloud. Make sure to grab your free subscription to manage 15 machines forever at smartdeploy.com/BTNHD.